The Florida Current, an online news service smartly covering politics and policy. Subscribe for free daily alerts at thefloridacurrent.com.
In a packed committee room, parents and teachers step to the mic to voice their concerns over the bill at hand.
This bill would pit parents versus teachers.
The legislation in question has been dubbed the Parent Trigger Bill. It would allow the parents of kids at failing schools to sign a petition to have the school turned over to a charter company. The petition would have to get signatures from a majority of parents.
That is the bill, Mr. Chairman.
In a House committee Tuesday morning, more than a dozen people waived their time in opposition to the bill.
Waiving opposition.
Waiving in opposition. Mr. David Bryant, also from Jacksonville, Florida.
I waive in opposition.
A dozen more chose to speak.
It uses parents during the time when they are most vulnerable and desperate.
We believe that this is nothing more than a continued ploy to turn our schools over to for-profit companies.
We can't afford more laws.
Only one parent spoke in favor of the legislation, Lenitra Daniels, who has three kids in the public school system.
I believe that having parents to have a active say in their child's education is needed.
The bill passed on a party line vote.
Reed?
No.
Stone?
Yes.
After the vote, we asked the bill's sponsor if the legislation would allow charter companies to run big money campaigns to take over a school.
For-profit charter schools are prohibited from spending money to influence parents under my bill. They're also, parents are prohibited from accepting gifts. You
know, the parent trigger bill almost passed last session, but it died in the Senate over concerns about what would happen to the public buildings if a charter school took over. Reporting in Tallahassee, I'm Whitney Ray.